practice black girl magic is more than a hashtag.
Yeah.
This is me, the chocolate beauty, deserving and saying I am queen. Dear black girl, no. That you are everything.
Woo! Be alive. Well, yeah, I don't know where to start with Be Alive. And honestly, when I was in the preconception of 2022, this was the one idea that I knew had to happen. You know, everything's up in the air until, you know, a certain point in the time frame. Be Alive was always a thing. It was always a thing. And I actually never knew it was gonna be the song Be Alive, but I just knew we were gonna do something like this. But it started off as a small seed of an idea where I was like, I need to do something to champion the black female talent in our cast, which at the time I didn't even know we were going to have any of. And what I have in my mind, and obviously what we've just watched at the Oscars with Compton and what she did with the beautiful dancers and like the scale of what she did, I was like, you actually can't do anything less. Like, you can't do anything less to that. Some things just have to leave, because you have to be able to do it justice to even do it at all. To be honest, I knew that whatever I did with Be Alive had to do that song justice, right?
Hi, my name's Aisha Vassal, and I was part of the Beyond, A Night Beyond Limits cast of 2022.
I'm looking at you.
Yeah.
You can tell I don't do this, right? I like to just have my voice speaking. But yeah, hi, I'm Kissy Isla, and I was in the cast of A Night Beyond Limits 2022.
For me, it was the so from last year, even when I was introduced to Beyond Limits, I was like, whoa, I've never been in a space and seen so many black girls, all these like different shades, different cut from different places. Whenever I go to class, for some reason, I never see enough black girls. I feel like I'm always like just the sprinkle of one or two. So when I got to Beyond, I was like, whoa. And then when they started dancing as well, it's just a whole completely different energy. Back, I was like, am I enough, but it's like, it makes you think how you look at yourself as a black person, as a black female as well. Like, can I live up to what everyone else is giving? But then you kind of feed off the energy, like everyone was nice, everyone's brings you in like a family, like a sister. No, there's no judgment. It was nice, and haven't felt that energy anywhere else that I've been, to be honest.
I would say that it feels really natural being like who I am at Beyond, because I think that's just the environment that you create for us. So I felt celebrated. I feel celebrated every time I'm at Beyond, because Black Girl Magic is there. It's really, really prevalent.
Okay, cool. Ready, babe. You do your thing.
And I think everyone that comes to Beyond is very inclusive. So like, I don't ever feel like awkward about like expressing who I am as a black woman, and that's who I am as a black woman, not what people believe a black woman is. So yeah.
Just different and amazing to be part of, because coming from like university, whereby I was probably like one or two black students in there, to then come out into the industry that actually has more than one, you know, black dancers in it. It felt amazing. Love the fact that you look around in the room and you see melanin.
When I was thinking about Be Alive, I was envisioning my mother. And in my head, I was like, oh, you know, you're thinking about this, it's nice, it's cute, your mummy's girl, that's my best friend, love you, mom. I never would have envisioned that she would be involved in what I'm doing like this, you know, should be like a cast member of what I'm doing. What? In my head, I just kept seeing my mum, the lyrics, feel so good to be alive, got all my family by my side. I grew up in an area that had no representation whatsoever. We were known as a black family, to be honest with you. That's how you know there was nobody else. And in the school, there was pretty much no representation. So, you know, black wasn't beautiful. You know, black was barely what you wanted to be friends with sometimes. You know, black wasn't popular, black wasn't beautiful. Black could be smart because, you know, grades speak for themselves. But black couldn't be the subjective, nuanced things that require social interactions. And at the young age of 13, you're a young girl. I've spoken to people in my adulthood and I'm like, whoa, you too? An age like that, you don't really understand even how you're feeling, why you're feeling it, and you can even blame yourself. You might even believe, like I did at the time, that what you had was wrong. It took me many years to be able to look back at that, heal from that, and now I love my skin. You know, I couldn't glow enough. Maybe 2 weeks before, when we had enlisted the dancers that were going to be joining us on that shoot day, I was like, the way I feel so excited to film with my mum, but also a bit scared, but the way I feel excited to film with my mum and just the healing that even asking her alone had given me, and the pride of like, and the joy of even just the experience of asking her on the phone on a quick little catch up that we're having one day, I was like, I want other people to have this. I want other people to enjoy this.
Lovely.
Aww. Overall vision, which I hope, having seen Be Alive now in its full glory, hope everyone took away from it that the vision was black women, we are everything. Everyone knows the embassy in this cast is she's the clown of the cast, and her smile is so big and so infectious, and to see her mum's smile be the exact same. And I was like, it's two Yemesis, I love it. Lydia and her mum and how they were dancing, and her mum does this little moment, I remember it, where she looks over her shoulder and that's sort of the first glimpse you get of her face, and you're like, it's literally Lydia times two. Like, this is just insane. Now here we come, all our bones hit it high. Where you bring parents in as an adult is a bit weird anyway. It made me feel very much like I was at parents' evening. It was very strange. And I was like, hi auntie, hi, you know, all this. But uncomfortable in a good way, in a way that was like, we need to see this more. We need to do this more. We need to educate our parents more about what we do, because, you know, sometimes the mums were there all day, some of them. So I would invite, if I saw one of their daughters doing something quite prominent, I'd be like, oh, let's get Aisha's mum up so she can watch her daughter right now, you know. And she was just there in awe of her child. Maybe, I'm not sure if she's had the chance to see it like that before, and not just for a phone screen or whatever it is, but she got to really see Aisha, the talented Aisha, in action. And
thank you so much, guys.
Yeah, and I'm very cautious to not give myself a God complex or claim that I'm changing the world, but quite honestly, that's one of the proudest things I've ever done in my career. Why did I even put mascara on? I never took it lightly, I still don't take it lightly. And it's just the beginning. I have so many plans. The night where we where we first watched Be Alive.
Everyone cried their eyes out.
Everyone cried, and I wasn't expecting that reaction. Funnily enough, I didn't think it was giving cry. I thought, like, I don't know, I thought it was giving, aww. Even when I was, you know, editing that together, did I cry? I was very moved. But I don't even think I cried, because I was so numb to it. I was just like, yeah, just put the creative together.
But I think even the people that weren't there in Spain, and people who didn't even know the meaning behind it, well, obviously when they watched it they did, but like the actual get into it, even they were touched and cried by it. Like everyone was moved in their own way, and everyone was crying their eyes out. Like, it was crazy, and it was, I think everyone felt so special to be able to witness that and to just be a part of that community and what you created.
Wow.
Yeah, for sure.
It's mental.
It was nice. It was good to see it.
Yeah,
it was beautiful. I was crying fun tears. Everybody saw the tears. And yeah, even just the beginning, like the beginning of the song is so simple and beautiful, and like I feel like there's such a lovely, gorgeous build up. So even to just see like Chanel start that off, it was just like gorgeous. And yeah, just to see everyone's mums, like, and again, as Aisha said, everyone looks like their mums as well. So just to see everyone all come together in that way. And I think the parts that were selected as well was like very, very intentional and very thoughtful. So I just think all together it was stunning. And even the moment where Cresta's mum like lifts her head up, it's just, it was perfect. So yeah, it really, really made me emotional. It still makes me emotional when I watch it. So.
You know, like there was a lot of cheers, obviously, when people see themselves and their mums and stuff, but I didn't even cry then. I was still just like, okay, it looks good. Yeah, because I'm in my head of, was it, you know, what was the color grading like on the screen? What was the quality like? Did the 4K drop, or, you know, did the shot, did it come out of sync with the audio? Did the shot look okay? Blah, blah, blah. Is it effective? All of this nonsense.
It was nice to not know what to expect. Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah, I was definitely there like, ooh, when is she coming? When am I coming? And I think one of my favourite lines in Be Alive is when she says, this is hustle personified, and that's when me and my mum appeared.
Can I just say that was intentional?
Was it?
Yeah, that was, oh my god, I didn't think, that was intentional because you guys were serving face, and I feel like the way that you guys were looking in that moment, it really looked like a hustler, like, but it wasn't giving me money, it was just like, we're hustling, like, you were really giving that, so I was like, yeah, that needs to go. I remember banking that clip to go there. I'm so glad that you, like, picked up on that.
Yeah, no,
Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model's size, but when I tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the span of my hips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips. I am a woman, phenomenally phenomenal woman, that's me. And that is a poem that I've loved forever. And I think it's low-key choreography. It's in the stride of my step, the what? That's 5, 6, 7, 8, honey.
To be alive, got all my family by my side, couldn't wipe this black off if I tried. I want you to tell these people where we are.
City of Compton.
Yeah, I think you can sing it like you mean it. Tell them where we are.
City of Compton.
Yeah. Break it down now.
I want to do a piece that not only creates a safe space for black women, but creates a space where they are celebrated, where a whole room of people are celebrating them, and where it's finally our time.
Give me some horns. Yeah, strength. Oh. Ladies, sing.
To the rain, the pain, and the fight. I'm gonna leave footprints in the sky.
Yeah.
It's not shared time. It's not abdicated time. It's time that we've taken, and it's time that we're taking unapologetically. And it's something I'm so passionate about.
It feels good.
I'm like, what are they? And I was like, oh yeah, crap, it's the mums. Like, it's the mums. So I was like, oh my god, let me go back and watch.
This is hustle personified. The
Which is amazing that I'm feeling that right now. And I'm so glad this opportunity came to me, but I don't feel scared anymore to be in a room if I'm just the only one. Because I feel like there's hope and beyond limits, you know, it shows like a night beyond limits. They're literally saying it all, and they're sort of like telling people that, right, all the black girls, all the young black girls that may be scared to, you know, walk into something, they're not really sure if they will be seen or if they will be turned down because their skin tone. I feel like this production particularly is speaking more.
There's this one shot and my mum is in the middle. She looks so powerful. And I was like, I've done it. It was that shot that was like, I've done it. I've depicted what was in my head. Because how she looked in that shot and how powerful she looked is genuinely how I've seen her my whole life. That shot, I was like, that's my mum. That is my mum. Soft, beautiful, feminine, you know, likes to laugh, is so nurturing and kind, and she's very human. But my God, does she stand tall and fierce? And that's all I've seen my whole life.
I feel like beyond limits, like what Emmy's saying, like me being at college, you are, again, just a sprinkle of a black, like this,
just a sprinkle.
And you don't really know what you're gonna get up to when you leave. And then I feel like a space like Beyond Limits, because there's so many of us, it makes it easier because we have each other to get through it, and we can connect with each other, we can help each other out, we can push each other through the process. And I think it's good, especially from now, 2022 onwards. I think we'll be okay.
There's a hope for the future.
Yeah.